All right, Alina, I want to bring in now Kevin Lacz, a retired Navy SEAL who served alongside Chris Kyle and plays himself an American sniper. Welcome back to the show. Thanks for joining us again.
Thanks for having me, Don.
What's it like knowing that Chris Kyle's widow, Taya, got to attend the Oscars with Bradley Cooper and was on the red carpet?
The experience has been incredible. It's great to see, you know, all that hard work and effort and Chris's story being told on such a large scale. It's great knowing that I was there on set every day training Bradley to help, you know, mimic Chris and help be Chris and help turn out that performance that, you know, got him an Oscar nomination.
Mm-hmm. She was holding his dog tags. What did this film mean to Chris Kyle?
It's Chris's legacy. You know, it's the story of Chris, it's the story of the people he served with, and it's the story of veterans that help, you know, shape this nation in the 21st century and help, you know, take the fight to the enemy and do a great job.
So you served two tours with Chris. You co-starred in the film. You even trained Bradley Cooper on how to shoot, and you just mentioned that. You were surprised that American Sniper only took home one Oscar for sound editing, were you?
You know, I was happy to watch the award ceremony last night. I got my SAG card. You know, got to train Bradley. He you know, turned out an Oscar-nominated performance. We're up for Best Picture. And, you know, the Oscars come and go each and every year. There's going to be an Oscar nomination next year, but there's not always a record-breaking movie like American Sniper, a top-grossing war movie, and it tells the story of Chris and the people that served with him.
That's what I was going to say. But, Chris, it brought in over $400 million, the biggest war movie of all time, and $400 million worldwide. Do you think maybe that there is a disconnect between what the public wants and what Hollywood, the so-called liberal Hollywood, want, and it, you know, it chose something different because of politics, perhaps?
Well, I think, you know, Sniper at the box office showed that, you know, the American public really wanted that movie. I think there might be a difference between the bags at the Oscars and the rucksacks in Afghanistan, but what the American public wanted was a movie that was true to the spirit of, you know, our military, the spirit of Chris Kyle, the spirit of the teams, and the spirit of us as a country and how we, you know, support our troops, not only when they're in the fight, but when they come home.
So beyond Hollywood, though, you say that it is, that one of the key things, and maybe one of the most important things about American Sniper, that is that it's bringing veterans' issues to the fore. How can we help veterans have a smoother transition when they come home?
Well, I think it starts by knowing what they've gone through and, you know, the cost of the freedom that we're able to share in this country. You know, going overseas, deploying for large periods of time is, you know, it's tough on the family, it's tough on the individual. So when they come home, do they have opportunities to go back to school, to start a job, to, you know, have to help their family adapt? And as long as we're receptive to listen to what they go through, then we can help them out in the path going forward.
So you're not really following the trial, are you?
I haven't been.
Yeah. I'm curious, though, how you think the Oscar snub will play down in Texas, though.
Yeah, I think snub's a tough word. Like I said, I mean, the movie did great. You know, it's a huge movie. It's an impactful movie. I hope the movie doesn't have too much direction as to, you know, the outcome of the trial. And, you know, I stand with, you know, a fair jury, and I stand with, you know, people making the right decision and staying under oath and, you know, let justice be served. And, you know, I have faith in Texas, and I have faith in our justice system.